Right. Today we're having a look at I Won't Back Down by Tom Petty and the Heartbreakers. No capo needed for this song. The chords are you'll find familiar, E minor, D, C, and G. And I do believe that is all. Yes. Okay, this song employs a really neat technique called palm muting. I think we visited it a while back, but you take a chord like E minor and you're trying to get this sound instead of that sound. The way you do that is you take the side of your hand, the side of your palm, you call this palm muting, and you put it so that that side touches all the strings right up near the bridge, not right on the bridge, but just before the bridge on all six strings. And you have to adjust the hand a little bit, move it around because you don't want that. That's too far away from the bridge. I can't hear the chord at all. If I'm right on the bridge, it sounds too much like a regular strum. But if you're just before the bridge, that's the sound you're looking for. You can still hear the chord, but it's muted. Okay? Not this. You can't hear the chord at all. Not this. You hear too much of the chord, but right before the bridge, that's the sound you're looking for. Okay? And it employs that technique throughout the song. Maybe on the chorus, you can let up on it a little bit so you get this. It there too. You might as well use it for the whole song. It's really fun. If your arm gets tired holding it weird like that, you can let up on it, the palm mute, but otherwise you can employ it for the whole song. So let's do a little playthrough here, and then we'll talk about how many strums and all that stuff. Come back to that part in just a sec. All right, so you're doing the palm muting and on the E minor, one, two, three, four strums, one, two, three, four on D, one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, or two times four, one, two, three, four, one, two, three, four on G, so eight altogether. Same thing for the next line. Then you get the C chord in the third line, four on E minor, four on D, eight on C, and then back to the original pattern, one, two, three, four, one, two, three, four, eight on G, then again. So it's four on E, four on D, and eight on G or C, depending on which chord they put in there, the Gates of Hell and Dragging Me Down. You have the C chord, and you do eight strums there for the verse. All right, now when you get to the chorus, you have to do some counting, easy counting, but you know it's I know it's a when things are uneven, even by one beat, it makes things really tricky. So I'm gonna guide you through this. Let's listen to it first and see what they do here with the chorus.
Stand up,
Okay. So just a super cool part of the song, but we have to do some counting here. So you start off with the C chord. And I know that they have some extra chords in there on Hey Baby, C, G, C. Leave the G out. Just do C. So we're going to go C, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 strums. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 1, 2 Then 2 on the G. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 Yeah. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 1, 2 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 Yeah. Then 6 on the D. Then 2 on the G. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 Wait a minute. I had this a minute ago. Sorry. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 1, 2 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 1, 2 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 1, 2 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 1, 2, 3, 4 Okay. So, yes. 5 on the C. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 1, 2 on the G. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 on the D. 2 on the G. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 on the C. 2 on the G. So that makes it a little easier. It's always 2 on the G than 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4 Then 9 altogether, but I on the D, on the word out, I count 5 strums and 4. That makes it easier for me to stay on track. Okay. So keep in mind, even though you're changing the number of strums on some of the chords, the G is a constant. It's always 2. So that makes it a little easier. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3. Then it starts over again on the Hey. 1, 2, on the second line of the chorus. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2. So 5 on C, 2 on G, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, oh, sorry, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, and then you do the 5 and 4 thing on the D again right before you return to this firm ground again on Stand My Ground. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, then you get back to your 4, 4, an 8 pattern like you had in the verse. So that's going to take a little love and attention, the chorus, and just a lot of counting. But if you write that down, and every chorus is the same, even though they throw in some extra chords that I'm not going to have you play because it's they're changing chords too fast. Just do every chorus exactly the way that we just discussed in the video, and you'll be fine. Let's see. Not seeing anything different here. The guitar solo is just the 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 That's all that is. And sometimes there's a G for 8. Sometimes there's a C chord for 8 beats or 8 strums. Let me see, what chords are the extra ones? 1, 2, 3. There's in the chorus, that first G, make sure you take that, cross that out every time, that first G chord that you see in the chorus, because it's just C. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4. And then all the rest of the chords are there. And then the D and the G in the second line of the chorus, take those out and just do C. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 1. And then the, I'm sorry. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4. Right. The 5 and a 4 thing on the D. And then the 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay. So you're only removing the G in the very first G of the chorus. And then in the second line of the chorus, the D and the G, you're removing those two chords and starting right on C on the word Hey. And then you should be okay. So like I said, a ton of counting at first, but hopefully we get used to that. If it's too much, we can always simplify too. That's always an option. But I think it's kind of fun having those different numbers of beats and not all the same. By the way, all downstrokes, there's no up strums, all down strums. When you're palm muting, it's kind of hard to do up strums. So it's all down. Okay, so have fun with this one and hit me with any questions anytime. Thanks for watching.